new session of English. We are going to learn a poem about rainbow. I will show you a small picture to you. Have you seen a rainbow? Yes, isn't it? Here, how many colors does a rainbow have? It has 7 colors. It looks so beautiful. So, we are going to learn the new poem of rainbow. I shall read it for you. I shall read line by line and I'll explain it to you. Okay. Boats sail on the rivers and the ships sail on the seas. But clouds that sail across the sky are prettier than this. See, boats sail on the rivers. Where do boats sail? Boats sail on the rivers. And ship sail on the seas. Where do ships sail? Ships sail on the seas. But clouds, where do clouds sail? It sails in the sky. We can see white clouds in the blue sky. It looks so beautiful. So here the poet says that the clouds are prettier than this boats and the ships. There are bridges on the rivers. We can see bridges on rivers. When we used to travel to some places, we can see bridges. Or near our place, it's a little Kallar, we can see a bridge. So, there are bridges on the rivers as pretty as you please. But the bow that bridges heaven and overtops the trees and builds a road from earth to sky is prettier far than this. So here the poet says that the rainbow looks prettier than all other things. So here we are seeing about the rainbow. So what does the rainbow seem to be making? It seems to be making a road from the earth to sky. The 7 colors look so beautiful. Whenever we see a rainbow, we used to look at it anxiously. Why? We are not seeing it daily. We used to see it rarely. We used to see a rainbow very rarely. Okay. So once more, I shall read the poem for you. Boats sail on the rivers and ships sail on the seas. But clouds that sail across the sky are prettier than this. There are bridges on the rivers as pretty as you please. But the bow that bridges heaven and overtops the trees and builds a road from earth to sky is prettier far than this. So this is the poem we have learned. And now I will give a few meanings. Okay, sail. The meaning of sail is travel on water. Meaning of sail is travel on water. Don't forget it. Travel on water. That's called sail. And next one, across. Across means from side to side. From one side to other side. Across means from one side to other side. These are the two meanings we have to learn. And then, okay, so noun is the name of person, place, animal or thing. I know you have learned it already in first standard, but we are recalling it. And see, noun otherwise means naming word. Noun otherwise means naming word. Noun means naming word, don't forget it. Okay, noun is the name of person, place, animal or thing. People's name we can see Hattie, Tom, Minnie, Sinor. All these things are naming words. Okay, people's name are naming words, otherwise noun. Place name, Mumbai, Chennai, Polycross, Nedugandam, Edugumbayan, Post Office, Police Station, Park, Hospitals. All these things are the names of places. There are some naming words. And animal's name, cat, dog, buffalo, lion, tiger. All these things are also naming words, otherwise noun. Thing, ball, bottle, Bible, Quran, Bhagavad Gita, desk, bench, chair. All these things are also naming words. So, noun means the name of person, place, animal or thing. Don't forget, noun is the name of people, place, animal or thing. Okay, so noun is the name of people, place, animal or thing. So once again, noun means naming word. Noun means naming word. And noun is the name of people, place, animal or thing. Now the next topic we are going to see is proper noun. We are going to see is proper noun. Proper noun. I should write the word. Proper noun. Proper noun means the name of a particular person, place or thing. See, proper noun means the name of a particular thing, place or people. Okay. So once again, proper noun means the name of particular person, place or thing. And now I shall say again some examples. People's name. Your name, your parents' name, your grandmother's name, your friend's name, all those things are proper noun and place name. Example, where do you live? You may say, I live in Elgumai. You may say, I live in Vattapara. You may say, I live in Nedumbanam. All these are also proper noun. And then the next question is, where do you go? Which hospital do you go when you fall sick? You will say a name, isn't it? St. John's Hospital or Medical Trust Hospital. So it has a name. Those names are also proper noun. And then thing. You may think what are the things which have a proper name. Monuments. You will listen it later. Now we will see the proper things what you know. Okay. Bible, Quran, Bhagavad Gita, Ramayana. All those are proper nouns because they have a particular name. And languages, they are also proper nouns. Hindi, English, Urdu, Marathi, Telugu, all those are also proper nouns because they have a particular name. So, proper noun means the name of particular people, place, animal or thing. So, I shall give some examples in the word. Okay.
Bangalore is a beautiful city. So Bangalore is a beautiful city. Here, which is the proper noun? So Bangalore is the proper noun. Here, Bangalore, the name of the place, particular place. This is a proper noun. See, and always listen, the proper noun always starts with capital letter. Remember, proper noun always starts with capital letter. So Bangalore is a beautiful city. And the next one is Ashok speaks Hindi. Ashok speaks Hindi. Here we have two proper nouns. You see, two proper nouns here. Ashok, the name of the particular person, and Hindi, that's a language. So Hindi starts with capital letter. See, Ashok and Hindi, these are proper nouns. And then one more I shall give you. This is the road to Delhi. This is the road to Delhi. See, Delhi is the name of a place and it starts with capital letter. See, it's the name of a particular place and it starts with capital letter. So this is the road to Delhi. Delhi is the proper noun. Look here once again. Bangalore is a beautiful city. Bangalore. This is the proper noun. Ashok speaks in Hindi. Ashok and Hindi, these both are proper nouns. This is the road to Delhi. Delhi is proper noun. So today we have learned noun and proper noun. Noun means name, word, name of people, place, animal or thing. And proper noun. Proper noun is the name of particular person, place or thing. So dear students, I'm going to wind up the class and the rest of the things will be given in the WhatsApp. Thank you.